Guyana is the only English-speaking country in South America. Mm. And is a very unique country in that is a country that is rich in natural resources, is a country that don't get no natural disaster, and is a country with a unique history. A history where the Africans in the diaspora who live in Guyana had to work the hardest of all the Africans anyway that come through the enslavement process. Wow. Over 400 million tons of ore by hand they had to dig up to create this land, because this land wasn't, this was swamp land. You see me? But they had to make it into a habitable place. You see me? 15,000 square miles. You said the amount of material to move is so much times the weight of the Great Pyramid.
Wow.
You see me? Yeah. Mm. And do it without machine. Thousands of miles of canals had to dig. You see me? And because it was swamp, it had a lot of serpents and reptiles and things. Roughly half of a million died. There at the bottom of this, we'll be talking about here.
This coastland.
Yeah, this coastland. We ancestors didn't get paid for it, and we asking the government of Guyana, the people of Guyana, to ensure that we get 18% of Guyana in lieu of what we ancestors made and didn't get paid for.
Can you repeat that again?
Right. I'm saying that we ancestors, half a million of them, they work without pay for create 18% of Guyana. The Africans in Guyana is making the call for 18% of Guyana, which was what was created by the ancestors. You see me, that today serve as the cultural, political and economic hub of the country that is today in the international world now known as the richest country per capita. But yet still the Africans as a major group in the land ain't even got 10% of the economy. You see me? Mm. Even though so much died building it. You see? Mm. So the call is being made for 18%. The Amerindians have roughly 13%. And you have people of other ethnic groups, individuals, who would have more land than the whole African Guyanese community put together. You see, man? Mm. So these things are an injustice that need to be corrected. You know, so let them know that in Guyana, the African spirit is alive and well, is vigilant, and would ensure that the Renaissance happens from Guyana. As we know, the bridge is built between Guyana and Ghana. There is no visa-free travel. Soon there will be direct flight between Guyana and other African states. And so I and I will be visiting, and we hope that the brothers and sisters in Africa also take the opportunity to come and to strengthen the revolution.
So what's the square miles for Guyana?
Guyana is 83,000 square miles.
And where is Guyana located?
Guyana is located in South America between Brazil, Venezuela, Suriname, and the Atlantic Ocean.
California, California, Londo, yeah, California, California, before.
Conakry,
insight on Cuffy is that Cuffy realize and Cuffy know that he's going to rebel against these slave masters and these colonial masters, because Cuffy has been seeing the wicked things and the wicked works that the slave masters has been doing to our brothers and sisters, which is his brothers and sisters too. And you know, day by day, night by night, you're seeing all these things, and you know that it can't continue. Someone have to take the stand. So Cuffy as the man who stand up with other warriors and prepare to fight and kill hundreds upon hundreds of these Europeans. So Cuffy had to do that. So I think we as Guyana and we as Guyanese people, we should respect Cuffy and we should give Cuffy a national holiday for the fight he has fought for us as Guyana and Guyanese people, black as it is.
Stretch on Hatfield Street, and we have Brick Dam directly in the middle of the two. So whenever you come here, you can come and check out Cuffy. This is one of our greatest freedom fighters, 1763, that fought against the Dutch in Berbice. Remember, Cuffy.
Yep.
Yeah.